This presentation is a part of the e-courses developed through the frame of the project Fruit Fly in Net with title A Location Aware System for Fruit Fly Monitoring and Pest Management Control. This particular presentation is related to Decor Package 4 with type Architecture at the Activity 4.2. Scenarios definition and requirement specification. In particular, the presentation has to do with the experimental design for the AUA or Agricultural University of Athens test site. The experimentation through this project, the Fruit Fly Net project, has the aim to compare the standard and the location aware system. We call it LAS techniques. The standard technique is a technique which is used by the farmer. It's a conventional, we can say, technique for pest control. The location aware system is a technique, the methodology that have been developed through this Fruit Fly Net project. The implementation of this comparison was based on scientifically sound methods according to the methodology that you use in the experimentation, in the scientific experiments. The design was the use of randomized complete blocks. That means we had treatment plots of location aware system, the standard or conventional plot, and the control plot. In the location aware plot, we had applied the methodology developed in this project. In the standard, the farmer developed the methodology that he had already adopted. This was a conventional plot, and in the control plot, we had no application of any control pest control measures, so that to show that the pest was present and could cause damage if left uncontrolled. The evaluation or the comparisons between the standard and the location aware system method was based on indicators. In the project, different indicators had been predetermined that were aimed to comparison between the two systems. So this kind of indicators were the spraying volume, the number of spraying applications, the number of trees sprayed, how easy or how locally applied was the sprays in the different plots. The aim was to show that the system could improve pest control with lower adverse effects on the environment and also by a higher efficacy to the conventional spraying. The structure of the pest control scenario in general consisted of these two major elements, the pest and crop monitoring. That means we need tools to monitor the pest populations. In fact, we need traps in the case of the olive fruit fly. We need traps to monitor the population of the pest, and also we need to monitor the phenology of the crop. It means that we need to know if the fruits are in a susceptible stage, or to see if the fruit fly females have started to lay eggs, and later to see if in the fruits there are larvae of the pest. So we need this pest crop monitoring, which has to be combined with meteorological data. Climatic conditions affect the population of the pest, their behavior, their egg laying. So the pest crop monitoring should be combined with the meteorological data. The meteorological data offer important information for the pest, the temperature, the relative humidity, and the precipitation or the wind speed. So we had to collect data also for the climatic conditions in the fields and to combine it with pest crop monitoring, and then through the development of the decision support system. That means a system that incorporates the information about the pest, the crop phenology, meteorological data, and decides if we have to spray or not. Then, if the decision is reached, we have to continue with the spraying application. The spraying application has also differences between the two methods, the conventional and the location aware system methodology, that which will be explained in the next slide. And then we collect the information for the indicators, which is used in the final evaluation of the new method. The components that we had to compare between the standard or NOLAS method and the location aware system, all last method have to do with pest monitoring, with meteorological data collection, with the decision system and the spraying application methodology. Starting with the first component, the pest monitoring, we have to consider that in the standard method, we have to go to the field and count the capsules on the traps. That means the number of flies that have been trapped on the sticky traps or the other McPhail traps, and then we have to collect samples of fruits or samples of leaves if we had another kind of pest. But in the location aware system, we have the advantage of the direct recording with the use of the e-traps. The e-traps have a camera adapted on them, so the image can be transmitted to remote places like in our computer in the office, and in this image we can identify the flies. In the collection of the meteorological data, in the first case, in the standard treatment, we have only a single sensor, but in the location aware system we have a network of sensors collecting data of temperature of relative humidity, and this data is interpolated in large areas so that to have a good much more detailed view of the conditions that exist in our area. And this is an advantage also for the control of the fruit fly. Then we come to the decision. In the case of the standard treatments or the standard methodology, the decision is usually manually operated by the farmer or by a consultant that has to decide based on the data that have been collected. But in the case of the location aware system, decision support systems have been developed based on that incorporate data on pest monitoring and meteorological data and pest biology, which sensors are computer assisted and then can produce maps with scale of risk so that to know with what density of spray we have to proceed during the spraying process, and then we can also have the real-time warning so that to know what happens in the field in each moment, in fact, because we can collect data many times. Essentially, we can collect data 3 or 4 times per day so that to have a view of what happens there in real time, in fact. And then after the decision, we come to the spraying application. The spraying application for the standard method is based on empirically based methodology followed by the farmer, but in the case of the location awareness, we can know and can consider the variety, the fruit load of each tree. This is important because some trees may have no fruit, so it is not need to spray them. We also know exactly the pest meteorological data with interpolated data to produce maps. In these maps, we can see, we can determine the different risk areas. In these areas, likely the spraying density can be different between them, so we save volume. Also, we can follow the tractor during the spraying, and then this helps to control the spraying volume applied. We can know exactly which tree has been sprayed and what was the amount of the spraying volume applied there, and also we can track the tractor path and calculate in example the fuel that was consumed by the tractor, or we can know if the tractor sprayed all the trees in the area as needed, and so on. So we can have a very precise information about the spraying application methodology. In the case of the AUA experimental design, in this figure you can see the olive orchard that was used our experimental design. This field was of 5 hectares of olive orchard located in the area of Koropi in close to Athens. In this orchard we had determined 3 plots. The A plot, this with the red line, was the last plot. The B plot was the standard or conventional plot, and the C was the control plot. The A and B plots had the same size and also the same shape. equal number of trees. We had also considered the buffer zones around these buildings here at the ends of the field, but also here close to B, which were buildings, and we had to protect them according to the legislation. And also we had considered the neighboring crops, which were mostly interested for the olive orchards around the our orchard. So we had the olive orchard here to in this place to the left and also to the right. That's why we had used these chirals. All the orchards was cultivated by a single variety of uniformly cultured in all the in the entire plot. So the tree age goes the same, the height, the fertilization, the irrigation, the pruning methodologies which were applied in the orchards were identical to the to all the plots. Post monitoring was based on the use of yellow sticky traps baited with ammonium bicarbonate. In the last plot we had established 5 E-traps, as you can see here with these green triangles. In the B plot we had established 5 sticky traps, conventional sticky traps without cameras. In the control plots also we followed the same methodology. The meteorological data monitoring was based on sensors which had been established. In the last plot we had established in fact 5 sensors for temperature, 5 for relative humidity, and also in the center there was one sensor for precipitation and also for wind speed. These two points are important during the application of the spraying.